He says, like, sometimes people show up too late. Sometimes we find them being extremely skinny, like Tara here. She's taking revenge, though. She's really, really one of the Hell's Angel girls. That's always a good one here. And others, like little Mickey, he traveled 12 hours down the river from a village. That was supposed to be sold together with, you see those two compartments? He had another friend in there who was following him, called Caspar. And they weren't really called that. We gave them that. Those names, obviously. in the interior of Borneo, they called them Mickey and Caspar. But he was so traumatized after these 12 hours. He'd never really been cared for very well. And the biggest dilemma with that, or those two orangutans coming in, was that the family that went down river, we were, somebody along the river, when they were coming down, alerted us by phone saying there's somebody who's going to sell these two orangutans that are arriving in this village approximately this time, they're going to go by car into Palanga Island, which is the main city, where they are going to sell them on the market. We managed to intercept them and get the orangutans. The unfortunate thing was that they weren't really needing that money. The reason why they came to Palanga Island was because their son was chronically ill. He had been ill for a very long time, and they needed that money to put him to hospital. Or put him in the hospital, I suppose. What do you do in a situation like that? They certainly couldn't put the little boy in the hospital. They couldn't get him treated. I'm not allowed to pay for the orangutans. I can't give people money when they have an orangutan. Because they're just going to go out and find another one and hope to sell it again. So we had to come up with an agreement. The best would be that we put the boy in the hospital and we pay the hospital bill, so there was no transaction money between us and the family. It would all come from the project to the doctor. And we made sure that this little boy was well taken care of, and we paid them to return to the village again. Hoping that, of course, they would never do that again. But they ended up traumatized. And our staff, I hate to say, I sometimes get traumatized too. I mean, I have had some of my girls sitting in tears, seeing the baby coming in, being so skinny and almost without hope that we're going to be able to help them. And they cry just as much as I do. This is what we normally see when we're driving around out there. And on this particular trip, I remember coming by this and thinking, that's a really odd chicken cage. And would you think it was anything else like a chicken cage? You know, I sort of thought it's a bit tall for a chicken cage, obviously, it would have been wider. But this was a bit odd. And when we got closer, we realized that it wasn't a chicken. It was a small baby orangutan. And if you see that little shelf, it's not even straight. She could not sleep on that because she would have just rolled off. So she was bound, she had to sleep on the ground at night. And this is why she was so muddy. We called her Bestie, because of plantation. My staff have to come up with all kind of funny names, you know, as they go out there. Because we've had about almost 1,100 animals going through the project. And unless you come up with something funny once in a while, you know, it's like, the plantation were called something PT, Best, something. And we thought, since it was a girl, we'll put a Y and we'll call her Bestie. But she was